I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
Robbie, you know what my problem is when I buy a lotto ticket?
Right.
I never check it.
Me neither.
I buy them, but I never check them.
It's all right.
But you know, I know three people who won already, like first one.
Yeah?
I know, this guy, my coworker, once, at one of the TV stations, won 95 million.
Mm.
The second that he won, he gave me 1,500. I'm like, why are you giving me money for?
95
million. Ooh. He bought a hotel, bought an airplane. He was living his dreams. Why not? I know a lady that won 340 million. She works from midnight to 8 a.m. It's for Channel 4.
Not too long ago. She's still working?
She said she was on Oprah.
Oh.
And she said, Oprah, I will never quit my job. 60 days. It takes 60 days to get paid. The day she got paid, she moved to Orange County, gone. But she was she was huge. She was fat as fuck.
I don't know them.
Yeah.
But just recently, not too long ago, there was like over $500 million in the jackpot. And right there where I live, it's one little town that nobody even knows.
Yeah.
Menifee.
Someone won?
Yeah, they won it right there.
Wow.
It was. They have the liquor store right there in Menifee, and people were making a big deal out of it because, you know.
Hey, that doesn't happen every day.
Small little town that nobody ever heard of.
So, what would you do if you won the lotto? You won $500 million, Robert. What do you do? Do you change your life? Do you change anything?
I won't change anything in my life, you know.
I'll take care of your kids, my houses.
Yeah, of course. Take care of my family.
But you're not closing the gym and...
fuck no. My father will be making $100,000 a fight. I'll be paying them. I'll be promoting and paying them really good. See?
You never check them.
Look at all those things I never check.
They're only good for 6 months. You gotta check them, Robert.
I never check them. They're good for 6 months?
Yeah. One day, give them all to me, I will go check them for you. And if I don't come back, you'll know why.
I don't know why.
No, I wouldn't do that. But seriously, put them all in one pile, I'll check them for you. You could go to any 7-Eleven, they have a machine.
Yeah, I've done it once in a while, if I could take a whole bunch and
But don't miss the date, because it's a shame
if you 6 months?
That, it may be a change. It used to be 6 months.
Uh-huh. I'm gonna go soon.
Yeah, but I put them in the laundry, I forget, I throw them out. But yeah, I know three people who won. So this lady that won, she went on Oprah and she said, I won't change anything. I'll stay working from midnight to 8 a.m. She changed everything.
What I would do is I would obviously secure my family. I have a big family.
Benny Lira.
I have
secure
cousins and good friends. Do a lot of things, you know. I would do like a good promotion for all my fighters. All my guys would probably be making a lot of money every fight.
But that's it. You wouldn't buy a mansion or a sports car or anything.
Well, I would live here in Riverside area, of course. You know, I would probably get a... Well, I have a nice house. My house is nice, so I probably wouldn't have
to. You have
a
nice pool? Not everybody has a pool like that.
I have a really nice house, so I probably don't have to.
See, but you don't go crazy with it.
Go crazy with it. No.
Maybe you buy a business.
Secure my kids, everybody. And enjoy life, but... I love what I do. So it's like, you know what I mean? It's like
Very few trainers, Robert, could train professionally full time. Very few. 99% of trainers in boxing have to have a day job.
Right.
I mean, very fortunate for you and maybe a handful of others.
Right.
But you think of like, even the biggest names in sports, when you think about them, they have to have a job, have to work. Yeah. Nobody's like doing it part time.
Well, I guess I've been blessed, but I love what I do and I worked hard at it. You know, I've been doing it for many years. I started, after I retired from boxing in 2001, I started helping out my dad with kids and this and that. And then I took on two of my friends to start training them. And since like 2001, 2002, and what is it, like, probably like 15 years I've been doing it. I love what I do.
If you were going a different route, and let's say you would have been a gym teacher, or let's say you would have done something else, you probably would have enjoyed it, but you wouldn't enjoy it like you're enjoying this.
You know, I was also working at high school.
Yeah.
And it was fun. I enjoyed too because I knew the principal. The assistant principal was my friend from. He was a little bit older than you, but we went to school together, and he was good friends with Mikey too, and all the teachers. A lot of them, not all of them. A lot of teachers that were there when I was in school. They were still teaching there, so I had fun. I didn't mind doing it. Then working with the Oxnard program.
Yeah.
The running the gym. It was fun. We used to take the kids to tournaments.
Red light,
red. It's not red, it's yellow.
As long as there's no cops, yeah.
We used to go to the tournaments and it was fun. Now as a professional trainer, sometimes it is a little tiring, especially every weekend traveling and not being around, you know, the house, home. It could get a little bit tiring or not tiring, but frustrated that you don't spend a weekend with your kids. I haven't had a weekend off, you know, all this summer, so I haven't been able to do nothing with my kids.
Nothing.
I haven't really been able to see my kids.
Till after Mikey's fight, right?
After Mikey's fight, yeah, I'm gonna take not even a full week, 4 days.
That's it.
4 day vacation.
And it's 5 hours to get there, plus the airport, so. But you're gonna meet some people from Hawaii coming to the fight.
Yeah, I'm already in touch with the one that you told me.
And I have another one that's coming.
Oh yeah? They're gonna pick me up at the airport, take us to eat and stuff like that. It's gonna be fun.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach. Take a step back. Elie Seckbach.